Now, this lady is one of the world's most loved TV mums, thanks to her portrayal of Mrs Cunningham on the hit 1970s sitcom Happy Days. And living legend Marion Ross proves she's still got that mother's touch as she welcomed our very own Craig Bennett into her lovely Hollywood home. And this is exclusive for Studio 10.
Well, how exciting is this? I'm in Los Angeles at the home of Happy Days star Marion Ross. She's invited us over for a look around and for a little glass of champagne. She's absolutely divine. I can't wait for you to meet her. Hello, Marion.
Hello, darling. Oh. You came.
I did indeed, and I've got bubbles.
Oh.
You got the glasses.
I know.
Should we go and treat ourselves?
You want to come in?
Do you want to come in?
Come on.
You're invited too.
You get to come too. Come on. I'm going to show you around Happy Days Farm.
Wow.
Yeah, so
this is spectacular.
Isn't this nice?
How beautiful.
Wow. It's like living out in the country.
Well, it is, isn't it, really?
Yes. Oops.
How beautiful.
Ah.
The wood, the stone.
Yes.
Look at that beautiful kitchen.
Oh.
You've made brownies. You've made brownies for little old me.
Because I'm so thrilled.
Oh, wow. I'm thrilled to be here.
You know
we're all thrilled to be here.
How much I love Australia.
You do it so well, too.
And Wollongong.
Sunday, Monday, happy day.
Marion, this is such a thrill to be with you and in your beautiful home, which is called Happy Days Farm.
Yes.
Obviously, you loved your time on Happy Days.
Well, I did, and every penny I made is sitting right here.
Mrs. C, Mrs. Yes. Cunningham, is in the history books as maybe America's favourite TV mum.
Yes.
Does that feel good?
Oh, I'd like that. There's a lot of competition. There's a lot of TV mums.
That's true.
Right.
But I think if TV mums were a Christmas tree, you'd be the angel on the top of it. How's that?
Well, if you asked the Fonz, what would he think?
I know what the Fonz would say. Absolute Mondo or something like that. Is that right? Somewhere
right.
there.
Right.
Oh, Arthur, you look very nice.
You and Henry Winkler, of course, as the Fonz, you became great friends.
And we are still. If he doesn't call me, I'll find messages from him. He's so busy now with his new series called Barry.
Yes.
I love to see him so happy with himself.
Fonzie, sit on it.
But you two had such a great chemistry back in those Happy Days days.
I did because I didn't get along so well with Tom Bosley, my husband.
You wrote that in the book. Why is that, do you think?
I don't know. He didn't like me. And I'm not used to being not liked. I spent my life making people like me.
How could he not like you?
I don't know. I think he wanted somebody else for that part.
Faye Dunaway was available.
I know. He missed out. He missed out. So over the years, I learned to love him so much.
Long after repairing their initial rift, Marion said goodbye to her TV hubby, Mr. C, who, sadly, died of heart failure in 2010. More recently, the world lost another Happy Days fave, Erin Moran, who died after a harrowing battle with cancer. She was only 56. You had the chance to chat with her shortly before her passing, didn't you?
Yeah, I did. She's a precious little child. Don't put your children into show business.
Is that the message? Is that what you felt with her? That
I did. Now, Ron Howard, a different story. His father and mother were actors. They knew how to handle him and how to protect him and take care of him. We had a Happy Days cast party. Ron's parents would take him home. Aaron's little young parents would stay and party all night. They were more interested in her career, maybe, than she. So you've got to have some pretty level-headed people involved in your life.
Oh, my behavior isn't that bad.
Is that why the teacher calls you Yak Yak Face?
Long before Happy Days, Marion enjoyed a busy career as a movie star. Take me back to when you were an aspiring actress. I think you were 21, you write in your book. You were waitressing and a big Hollywood honcho zeroes in on you and invites you to his apartment.
I got a job, you know, to serve dinner at somebody's house, and they said, this young lady wants to be an actress. Oh, he said, man came to the kitchen, gave me his card, come see me. So, okay, well, It did turn out to be his apartment. He says, how do you think you're going to get anywhere? I said, well, I'm really, really good actress. I'm 21. And as he's making his big play for me, you know, I said, you have no character. Right in there, you have no character. I'm married. You know, I can't do things like that. Because he says, I could take you. I'll take you around parties. I'd be sure that you meet everybody. I thought, no. He didn't know what to do with me, so that's the end of that.
But good for you, though, for sticking to your guns.
I know.
And not being taken off into a bedroom somewhere.
No.
You're the one with the character. He had none.
I know, he had none.
Marion's resilience was put to the test again, this time in the 60s. Her acting work had dried up, there was a costly divorce from her husband of 18 years, and all the while, she was struggling to raise two kids. With her finances dire, money was so scarce, Marion couldn't even afford a hairdryer.
No.
It was that time.
I rented a bedroom out of my house.
To earn some money to keep afloat.
Yeah. Keep the house going.
But that non-speaking, almost insultingly small role in the 1970 disaster epic Airport became her one-way ticket to TV superstardom.
Every actor there was in trouble. I was getting a divorce, so everybody there...
They were there for a reason. They needed the money.
They needed that job. Mm. And because of that job, I met Sandra Gould.
From Bewitched.
Sat across the aisle from me in the plane. One night she has me... And I cry every day because my life is a mess. And we're extras in this movie and spend hours doing nothing. So she invites me for dinner and she invites this casting woman. And then the casting woman said, you'd be good for the mother in this Happy Days thing we're going to do. And the next thing you know, you're on Happy Days.
And the iconic all-American TV mum continued to achieve fabulous success long after Happy Days, starring as Captain Steubing's wife in The Love Boat. And as Shirley MacLaine's loyal housekeeper in The Evening Star.
I've never considered you my boss. I've considered you my friend.
But it appears there was room for only one ravishing redhead on the set of the 1996 Terms of Endearment sequel.
How did you find Shirley all those years on?
I found her very competitive.
Really?
So I could see her watching me. That was good for me. Because that made me really...
Gave you some edge, didn't it?
And I'm playing the plainest. She'd be like, check me out to see what work I'd had done. I would think, oh, okay. I had to become plainer and plainer and plainer and plainer till finally they got a little funny wig for me and put a bobby pin over here and I was brought down, brought down, brought down.
Wow, that was the competitive nature of Shirley MacLaine, eh?
Yeah.
While Marion has officially retired from acting, it appears a little bit of Mrs. C lives on. She spends her days playing bocce ball, baking delicious brownies, bonding with her beloved kids, and kindly welcoming showbiz reporters like me to her Happy Days farm.
Can I toast you?
Oh, can I toast to you?
I had such a wonderful day with you.
Haven't we had fun?
We have.
Oh, geez.
Yes.
Mrs. C, if you want to read more about Marion's extraordinary life, her latest book, My Days, Happy and Otherwise, is out now. Another cracking interview there by Craig B.